3 weeks ago, I found a video about him. Fortunately, I was in Kenya, which is located next to where he is. So I decided to meet him. I took a flight to his country. And after I drove 13 hours, I arrived his place. Let me introduce my special friend. Meet Zanziman Ali. He's 22 years old and he's living in a little village in Rwanda. Ali was introduced at the first time to the world by Afrimax. He was born with microcephaly. If a baby was born with microcephaly, the baby can become paralyzed easily. Also, it has a really high chance of losing its life. But thank you, Ali, you made it. His mom said Ali liked to go to jungle for a walk, so I decided to go with him.
Let's run! Oh, be careful! Be careful! No, too fast!
Ali! Where are you going? We have to go back!
We had a lot of fun. I can't forget that he used his hands and said like, let's run, I wanna run more. He was an energizer, and I hate my body.
You're too fast!
I had a question to myself. What can I do for them? I'm not an influencer or a millionaire. I'm just a traveler who make videos. So I can't give them $10,000 or a brand new house. But what they want. We went to supermarket and I said, from here to the end, if you see what you need, please take it. Fortunately, she wasn't really happy with that. And I didn't expect that she was staring at a perfume. Because when I visited a house where they used to live, it looked like a little bit far from a perfume. She was hesitating about it. So I said, take it, you deserve it. 20 minutes later, I realized that there are a lot of people outside of the supermarket to see him. She told me it's uncomfortable. So immediately, I took him to my car and I just drove far away from them. Because I really hate what they were doing to him. They took a picture with laughing. Even they were trying to touch his head. Now I understand why he has a lot of scars on his skin. When he was young, there were a lot of bullies who didn't like his looks. This is a really sad part. Bullies called him monkey. When I watched a video about him at the first time, I cried a lot. Not because he needs help, because even his living hard with a lot of challenges, he never lost his smile. When the time to leave came, I really didn't want to leave, but I had to. So I headed to my car. Suddenly, he gripped my hand and he pointed at the door of the car. He wanted to get in. So I spent 30 minutes more with him on the backseat. Zanziman Ali, please don't give up, Ali. There are a lot of friends out there who loves you. And for me, he's just a normal man who has a beautiful smile. Thank you for watching.